I'm going to ask you a question. We have friends wherever we go, all stages of our life, starting from our kindergarten, we have friends. We go to middle school, we have friends. We go to high school, we have friends. We go to college, we have friends. We go to university, we have friends. And then we get married, we have friends. We get retired, we have friends. And we get buried, we have friends. Hallelujah. These are people who follow us all through the days of our life. Of course, some people change friends each hour. In the early 2000s, Mark Zuckerberg, me andar telusu, he created Facebook. Everybody uses Facebook. Not now. It has declined. But the word friend has changed after he introduced Facebook. Everybody had gone to friendless. ముక్కు మొహం తెలియని వాళ్ళు ఫ్రెండ్ రిక్వెస్ట్ పంపిస్తారు, వాళ్ళు ఫ్రెండ్స్కి యాడ్ చేసుకుంటారు. అప్పుడు దాకా ఫ్రెండ్స్ అంటే తెలిసిన వాళ్ళు. ఆ తర్వాత ఫేస్బుక్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత ఫ్రెండ్షిప్ అనే దానికి మొత్తం మారిపోయింది. హౌ మెనీ ఆఫ్ యూ యూజ్ ఫేస్బుక్? ప్లీజ్ రైజ్ యువర్ హ్యాండ్స్. ప్రైవేట్ అకౌంట్స్ ఆల్సో, రైట్? ఎవ్రీబడి యూజెస్ ఫేస్బుక్. సో మార్క్ జుకర్బర్గ్ చేంజ్ ద వే వర్డ్ ఫ్రెండ్షిప్. సో యూ ఆల్ హ్యావ్ మేడ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ వితౌట్ నోయింగ్ వాట్ ఈస్ ఫ్రెండ్షిప్. You want me to become David and become a person next to your own heart and extract the meaning from your heart? David gaga neng hrudayam sar laga mari mee hrudayam lonchi mee meaning download cheskovalantara? Anta goppa vaadu nen kaadandi. If you look at the Oxford dictionary, it says friendship is a bond between two people providing mutual support and understanding. Friendship is a bond between two people which provides support and understanding. That is what the Oxford dictionary states. Now friendship is different for different people. Some people have friends, long lasting friends. Some people break friends. Some people change friends depending upon their moods. But before going on to all these things, if you look at the Bible, there are many friendships starting from God and Abraham. Abraham was God's friend. God himself has said that in the Bible. And then we move on, and then we find David and Jonathan. And then we move on and we find many other friendships, but I'm still mentioning only the top ones. Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego and Daniel, they had a good friendship between them. And then we move on, and in the New Testament, Jesus Christ himself has said, you are my friends if you follow my commandments. Hallelujah. Prabhu Yesu Christu varu ayan chepparu, meeru naa snehithulu naa commandments follow aithe ani New Testament lo you can clearly see it written. So there are a lot of type of friends, but I'm not going to go through these friends. I'm going to go through some other thing. But before we go into all these things, let's bow down our heads and let's pray. Loving Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity to come into your presence again, Lord, as we're going to talk about friendship today. The power of friendship today, Lord. Lord, let not my words come out, but let your words come out. Let your wisdom prevail, Lord. I'm not here prepared and standing here to deliver my message, but I'm here for you to fill my mouth with your words that I can deliver it, Lord. Use me as a mouthpiece only. Give the audience the listening spirit and the Holy Ghost anointing so that they can understand what I'm speaking, because it is for them. In Jesus' most precious name I pray. Amen. Okay, let's quickly open our Bibles to Acts 9 chapter from 1st verse to 9th verse. What you see is the transformation of Saul. Now this man, as you know, Saul was persecuting Christians. Christavulni andaru andarni he was putting in jail. He was against Christianity, he was against prophets, he was against Jesus. All the commandments of all the people who were following the commandments of Jesus were being persecuted by him because he was into the Roman side unnadu. And then, as you know, God is a God of miracles. God uses anybody and makes them to the best possible reason. So what happens here is in the third verse, 9 chapter, third verse. Yeah, so God started breaking down Saul here. Saul was breaking down God's people until then. Saul was persecuting God's people until then. But God has decided, he has waited, he has looked upon Saul and said, now it is your time to start me, to pull you to me. And that's what God does here. He started breaking down Saul. Atharvata, adhe 9 chapter, 9th verse lo ganaka chusinatlayite. And he was 3 days without sight, neither did he eat or drink. So imagine, on one side this man was very strong, he was persecuting people, all people were afraid of him. Now on the other side, this man is now shocked, amazed, because he's hearing voices from the heaven. He knows that God is speaking to him. Now he has no food, he has not drunk anything, and he has not eaten anything for 3 days. He is put into fasting. Compare the transformation. God is a God who is a perfect God. When he transforms people, he breaks them down slowly. Hallelujah. And Saul was being broken down slowly from a man who was persecuted to a man who is now fasting for God, changing his life from plan A to the best plan possible. And then this man, aa parisithulu man chusinatlayite, he was probably sad mood or frustrated mood or a depressed mood because he doesn't know, he don't know what is happening. He lost his sight. I'm sure everybody loves their sight. If Jesus Christ shuts your eyes for 5 minutes, I'm sure everybody will go and will start getting frustrated and parigetaremo, paaripotaremo anta bayapadipoyi. But still, what happens here, we'll see, God has a different plan. And that's why we see here in the, let's look at the 10th verse. So immediately God is starting his solution here. He has broken down Saul. Saul is now in a broken state. God breaks down people, Christian people, his people, whatever people, the people he has made. There is more chance for this person's life to be changed through the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. And when there is more chance for this life to be changed through Holy Ghost, that is when the person comes and changes his life. That's why Ananias ikkada chusi maatladutunnadu. See what Ananias says here in the 12th verse. Ananias is saying, Lord, you're asking me to go and meet this guy who has been persecuting Christians. This guy is a terrorist. This guy has been persecuting your people. This guy has been putting them in jail. And now you're asking me to go and meet this guy and make things happen for him. And I'll tell an example. You know, in Mumbai, Kasab and his team killed hundreds of people a few years ago. If God asks you to go and meet Kasab, of course he's not present here. If God asks you to go and meet Kasab and speak to him and become friends with him, how many of you will go forward? Ajmal Kasab, me andar telusu. The man who killed more than 100 people with just his AK-47 and a few grenades. How many of you are gutsy enough to go forward and meet that man and become friends with him and change his life? Will anybody go forward? Anybody go forward here? I will not go forward. But you see, this guy, this prophet Ananias was terrified because he's going to meet a terrorist. But God had different plans. God said, Ananias, I'm going to give you a new friend. Hallelujah. You might be thinking this man is a terrorist. You might be thinking this man has been persecuting my children. But this man, let's see what he says. In the 15th verse, we see testimonies of people who are Maoists, people who are terrorists, people who were in the ISIS, people who were in a lot of terrorist groups coming to Jesus Christ because God speaks to them. No matter how far you have gone back, God will still bring you back. Hallelujah. And that's why Ananias became friends all here. He was not Paul then. So let's see what Ananias does. We go into the 17th verse. Yeah, so first point, what we are going to talk about is, the first point is, as a friend, number one, you don't have to do a lot of things. You have to be there. Amen? You have to be available for your friends. You have to be there. God said, Ananias, go. Ananias might have said, Lord, I'm shaking, I'm shivering. This man will kill me. I'm not going to go. If Ananias didn't go and meet Saul, Saul's life must have, of course, God would have chosen somebody else, but Ananias has played a big role in changing Saul's life. And he goes, first time, and he goes, ipde 17th verse, man chadivamo. What he does is, if somebody can read it, please. He enters into the house, placing his hands on, and Saul, and? Brother Saul, hallelujah. This man was a terrorist few minutes ago. Same Ananias was afraid of Saul. Same Ananias was talking to God and saying, Lord, this man was persecuting our people. How are you sending me to this man? And then the same Ananias now has changed in mind and he has completely entered in the scene and become friends with Saul and he puts his hand. Okasari Saul lopala em jarutundo manu okasari uhinchukunte. He was blind, he was hungry, he was thirsty. Somebody puts his hand on his shoulders and says, brother. Probably tana heart melt ayipoyi untadi. Because he was expecting care from somebody. He was expecting somebody to come and redeem him. He was expecting somebody to come and save him and help him. But then Ananias comes to the rescue. So the second point what we see here is, you have to be gentle and act right with your friends. I'm not telling you some top points here, but analyzing Ananias' behavior, he was very, very gentle. Adhe Ajmal Kasab jail digar mana yelli man nunchunte, manchiga indi, anta mandini champavu kada. చెప్పులు తీసుకొని కొడతారేమో కొంతమంది అయితే ఒకవేళ వెళ్తే. నేనైతే నిజం చెప్తున్నాను, చాలా మంది అంత కోపం. ఆ న్యూస్ వచ్చినప్పుడు అజ్మల్ కసబ్ మాకు అప్పగించండి అని ఎన్నో పార్టీస్ అడిగాయి, సో దట్ ఐ కెన్ డీల్ విత్ హిమ్. ఒకవేళ సౌల్ ఛాన్స్ దొరికినట్టే. అనియస్ ఈస్ నాట్ డూయింగ్ దట్. హీఈస్ నాట్ క్వశ్చనింగ్ సౌల్. హీ సేయింగ్ బ్రదర్, విచ్ మీన్స్ హీ ఇమ్మీడియట్లీ మేడ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ విత్ సౌల్. హల్లెలూయా. సెకండ్ పాయింట్ ఇస్, యూ హ్యావ్ టు బి జెంటిల్ అండ్ రియాక్ట్ ద రైట్ వే అండ్ ద రియాక్షన్ కమ్స్ నెక్స్ట్ నెక్స్ట్ వర్స్ ఏం చేస్తాం ఒకసారి 18th వర్స్ చూసినట్లయితే పొరలు వంటివి రాలగా లేచి బాప్తిస్మము పొందెను తర్వాత ఆహారం పుచ్చుకొని బలపడిను. దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్. ఐ సీ అ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. వాట్ వి సీ ఇస్ బర్త్డే జరుగుతుంది, బర్త్డే కాలేజ్కి వస్తారు, బర్త్డే బంప్స్ అని ఉంటుంది. ఏం చేస్తారు తెలుసా, మీ ఏందో తెలియకపోవచ్చు, కాళ్ళు చేతులు రెండు కాళ్ళు రెండు చేతులు ఒకటి పట్టుకొని ఒక గుంపు కలిసి వాడిని బాగా కొడతారు వాటి బర్త్డే రోజు. అది కూడా చేత్తో కాదండి, కాల్తో. మీరు చూస్తే వీళ్ళు ఫ్రెండ్సా, గొడవ అవుతుందా, పోలీస్ కంటే 100 ఫోన్ చేద్దాం అనుకుంటారు మీరు. ఎవ్రీ కాలేజ్ హ్యాప్ యు సీ దిస్ అండ్ ద సేమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ హూ లివ్ టుగెదర్ హూ స్టడీ టుగెదర్ హూ ఎంజాయ్ టుగెదర్ దిస్ సేమ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్ యూస్ ఫౌల్ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఆన్ ఈచ్ అదర్స్. అది పెద్ద స్టైల్. ఐమ్ టెలింగ్ యూ వన్ థింగ్, ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ అ ఫ్రెండ్ అండ్ ఇఫ్ సమ్ పీపుల్ ఫైండ్ దిస్ కూల్ దట్ గై సెలబ్రేటింగ్ హిస్ బర్త్డే, it's a special day for him and you are kicking him, does it make sense? No, to be honest, no, not at all. This man Ananias didn't do that. He didn't go to house and kick him, but instead put his hand gently on Saul's shoulder and said, brother Saul, say the Lord appeared to me, and immediately he received the Holy Ghost. And tana appudaka 3 days varaku kannedadu kanapadaledo, they opened up and he started to see. Hallelujah. So Saul was redeemed by the friendship of Ananias. And that moved on. If next verse is going to chalan laithe, in the 20th verse. Yeah, so what we see is Saul immediately after he was strengthened, after he received the Holy Spirit, after he was baptized, he started preaching. And he wanted to meet up with the disciples of Christ. But then the disciples of Christ were not trusting him. Of course, it's not that easy for them to trust, because this man a week ago was persecuting the same people now. So they were hiding. అందుకనే చూస్తాం ఒకసారి 26 verse లో, అదే chapter 26 verse. If you see the process, Saul was first broken down, then God spoke to him, and then God sent a friend for him for the initial solution, for the initial process of breaking him down and changing him. Ananias became his friend, and then he completely gently treated him and baptized him, and Saul started preaching. Now when Saul started preaching, of course everybody were not trusting him. He wanted to meet the disciples, but nobody were trusting him. So in this situation, Barnabas comes into situation, and Barnabas becomes the second friend of Saul. Hallelujah. And Barnabas becomes the second friend of Saul. Andaru namakam undinappudu Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles. And then if you see in the Acts 11 chapter 25th verse, Barnabas and Saul Antioch vachi akkadunna churches mottham, they handled things together. So the third point what we see here is trust and support. That is probably the best definition I can give for friendship. As friends, you have to support each other. So today, afterwards, Saul becomes Paul. Paul becomes a great man in the New Testament. All his writings to the churches, the impact he has on a Christian world, and then he becomes a martyr later, the Hathasakshiga martyr. Now imagine these two incidents. Imagine the incident between Ananias and Saul, and Barnabas and Saul. Okvela Anania Barnaba Saul ni ganka friendship ganka lekapoyunte, ee roju Saul లోకానికి తెరల క్రిందలు అయ్యేవాడు కాదేమో. ఐఎమ్ ష్యూర్ బికాస్ దే హ్యావ్ పోర్ట్రేడ్ అ గ్రేట్ ఇంపాక్ట్ ఆన్ హిస్ లైఫ్ అండ్ ది ఇంపాక్ట్ ఆన్ ద క్రిస్టియన్ వరల్డ్ ఇట్ సెల్ఫ్. అండ్ పాల్ హెస్ రిటన్ మెనీ వండర్ఫుల్ స్క్రిప్చర్స్ దట్ వీ హవ్ రిటన్ దట్ వీ హవ్ సీన్. సో టుడే డియర్ బ్రదర్స్ సిస్టర్స్, ఫ్రెండ్షిప్ ఇస్ నాట్ సంథింగ్ దట్ లాస్ట్ లాంగ్, బట్ ఐఎమ్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ క్వాలిటీ ఫ్రెండ్షిప్. ఇట్ డజన్ హ్యావ్ టు లాస్ట్ లాంగ్, బట్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ టు బీ ఆఫ్ టాప్ క్వాలిటీ. హల్లెలూయా. ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ అ ఫ్రెండ్, let me tell you, doesn't have to be all through your year of life, and if it doesn't impact you, if it doesn't support you, if it doesn't help you change from a person to a better person, then there is no use of having a friend. But I'll give you my example. Nenu 13 years appudu nenu baptism teeskunanu teenage ga ochinappudu, and I was always told by my mom about friendships. I'm of course, everybody will agree with me, if you have friends who smoke, you will smoke. If you have friends who will drink, you will drink. If you have friends who go to the pub and movies, you will go to the movies. If you have friends who bunk classes and do all sorts of nonsense, you will also do the same. Some people think, I'm going to change my friends and make them like me. That is impossible unless you are somebody like Saul or Paul or the disciples. We are not as strong as them, as spiritual as them, as powerful as them, and as God-powered as them. I had always less than 5 friends. When I was in intermediate, I had 3 friends. Of course, upper chinna age, but the main friendship started when I hit BTEC. Then BTEC chadutunappudu, I went to the college, first college, I was looking at everybody. I found 3 people who were people like me or match my type. I'm not saying I'm somebody great, but we always look for similar people like us. I'm sure you will agree. So I was looking at them, and then 4 years passed by. My college mottam lo, only we four have settled in the top positions. I have four friends. Nobody watches movies. Everybody is single. Nobody drinks, nobody smokes. And one guy is placed in Oracle, one guy is placed in Google, two have placed in Infosys, and we are wonderfully settled. Why? Didn't we enjoy? A lot of youngsters say, "Anna, friendship ante enjoy cheyal kada." We did not drink, but we enjoyed. We did not smoke, but we enjoyed. We were single all through the way, and we are single now. We enjoyed. We didn't have fashionable bikes, fashionable clothes. We didn't have Hayabusa, but we enjoyed. So every youngster who's seated here and who's talking about friendship and saying, enjoyment is not doing things against God, I'm telling you this. Enjoyment is not doing sinning. Enjoyment is something different than most people think. You don't have to go to pub to enjoy. You can go without your good friends, but you don't have to do wrong things. Why am I saying all these things is, through the grace of God, I had good friends. They have impacted a lot in my life. The way I study, the way I move on in my life. So my testimony is, all these friends that God has given me have impacted greatly in my life, and they have been good friends. So, dear brothers and sisters, if you have friends today, it's not about plain friendship. It's not about long-lasting, non-benefiting friendship. Because friendship itself says mutual trust and support. If you're not getting mutual trust and support, then that means you don't have friends. And if you're still saying you're having friends, then they are dummies. So, on this friendship day, more than talking about friendship in the Bible, let's create quality friendship in this world. Let's forget the people who don't support us. As friends, they have to. So if you have friends, hold on to them. Be quality, show quality of friendship in your life, and God will bless you. Let's pray. A loving Heavenly Father, I thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity, Lord. Lord, we have a lot of friends in our life, Lord. Lord Jesus Christ, you yourself have said that if we follow your commandments, we are your friends, Lord. Lord, many times in our life, friends play an important role, starting from our education to our retirement and the death stage, Lord. They are people who stay with us, who impact a lot in our lives, onto our lives, Lord. Lord, as youngsters, many people are seated here, let them have the best friendships possible. Let them not look for the worldly thing. Let them not just look for pointless things. Let them understand that friendship is more than just enjoyment. Friendship is more than doing things that are cool. Friendship is more than things that are sinning. Friendship is more than just, Lord, bunking classes and doing whatever they want. Lord, Ananias was given to Saul as a friend. Ananias helped Saul. He mutually supported him. Lord, he supported him and he treated him gently. And Saul was broken down and he was evolved into a person who could preach in your churches. From a person who was persecuting to a person who could preach about you, Lord. Lord, then he lacked trust among people, but then you sent Barnabas as another friend, Lord. Barnabas showed trust in Saul. He was always with Saul. He was always with Saul all through the journey and all through his life. Lord, today as we have friends in our lives, give us friends like these people. Friends who will support us. Friends who will impact our lives positively. Not friends who will do wrong things with us. Not friends who support us in doing sin. Not friends who support us in doing things which you, Lord, hate. But friends who will help us, friends who will show us the right way, and friends who will hold our hands in times of trouble and treat us in the positive manner, Lord. Lord, you changed Saul from a persecutor to a martyr, Lord. A person who died for you, a person who craved for you, a person who has transformed many people in this world through his scriptures, through his preachings, and through his gospel, Lord. Lord, today, let our friends be such impactful friends. Let our friendship be of such quality. Lord, no more normal friendship, no more passive friendship, but let our friendship be active and, Lord, the best possible. Lord, in this friendship day, Lord, on this friendship day, Lord, bless every person who's seated here. Let them acquire this wonderful friendship from everybody possible. Let them maintain this quality all through the days of their life. In Jesus' most precious name I pray. Amen.
మన తండ్రి అయిన దేవుని దీవెన, కుమారుడైన క్రీస్తు కృప, పరిశుద్ధాత్మ యొక్క అన్యోన్య సహవాసము ఈరోజున విత్తిన వాక్యం మన జీవితంలో నూరంతలుగా ఫలింపచేసి ఆయనని స్నేహితునిగా కలిగి ఉండే స్థాయికి మనం హెచ్చించబడే వరకు సదాకాలము తోడయుండునుగాక. ఆమేన్.
ని పాడి స్తుతించదిరది జనులారా మనసారా ఊరురా అదే జనులారా మనసారా
అందరం లేచి నిలబడి దేవుని స్తుతించుకుందాం
హల్లెలూయా ని పాడి స్తుతించదిరది జనులారా మనసారా ఊరురా
యేసుక్రీస్తు రక్షకుడని ఆయన సిల్వ యాగము ద్వారా పరిశుద్ధ రక్తాన్ని చిందించి పాపులమైనటువంటి మనకు విమోచించాడని మోక్షాన్ని ప్రసాదించాడని నిత్యరాజ్యానికి వారసులు చేశాడనేటువంటి గొప్ప విశ్వాసముతో మనము ఎప్పుడైతే మన జీవితంలో ముందుకు వెళ్తామో ఆ విశ్వాసాన్ని చివరి వరకు తుద వరకు అదే స్థిరమైన దృఢమైన విశ్వాసాన్ని కలిగి ఉన్నప్పుడే మనము అక్కడికి చేరుకోగలుగుతాం.
ప్రాణమా
మోసపోకుడి దేవుడు వెక్కిరించబడ్డు.
మంచి గృహాన్ని దయచేసిన ప్రభువును బట్టి నీకు స్తోత్రం చెల్లిస్తున్నాం తండ్రి. గొప్ప దేవుడు ఎప్పుడు నీ కనికరం నీ కృప మా పట్ల ఉంటుంది బట్టి స్తోత్రం.
ఈ ఆశీర్వాదం
బట్టి ప్రభా మేము ఉండడానికి మీరు ఇచ్చిన గృహాన్ని బట్టి నీకు స్తోత్రం.
ఓకే దేవా, ఈ ఆశీర్వాదంగానికి ఒక గృహం ఇమ్మని అడుగుతున్నావు, మరి నువ్వు ఇష్టమైనది చూస్తా నేను.
ప్రతి జనమునకు నీ ప్రభువు పుట్టించను.
దేవుడు మిమ్మల్ని దీవించను గాక.